If you followed my tutorials to build a USB adapter for your Logitech G25 or G27 shifter, you might have noticed that the power LED doesn't light up. The LED doesn't come on when the shifter is powered. It's driven by its own input pin. And because it's not necessary for the adapter to function, I didn't include it in the video. But it's really easy to add if you want the LED to be on, and we can even control it from the Arduino. You'll need another piece of 22 gauge solid core wire, about 7 inches long. I'm using blue wire, and I added a black stripe to distinguish it from the existing clock wire. Open up the connector's case, unscrew the strain relief bracket, and take out the connector. Strip one end of the wire and bend it at an angle. Spread the existing wires to make space, unscrew the terminal, and connect it to pin 5. Then put the connector back into its case. Inside the shifter, the LED has a 330 ohm resistor. That means we don't need to add another one, but if you have a G25 shifter, I'd recommend adding a 100 ohm resistor in series, so that the power and sequential mode LEDs look similar. To keep things solderless, I'd recommend using these Wago lever nuts. You just open the lever, insert the wire, and close it again. You can also use a solderless breadboard. Again, don't worry if you don't have a resistor, this will still work with just the bare wire. Now we have two options for connecting to the Arduino. The simple option is to connect the wire to ground. Whenever the adapter has power, the LED will be on. The more fun option is to connect the wire to one of the Arduino's I/O pins. I'm using pin 8. In the example code, change the LED pin to 8 and re-upload the firmware. The LED will be on by default, and we can control it using the library's setPowerLED function. I wrote some demo code for this, triggered by the shifter's action buttons. We can turn the LED on, turn it off, make it blink, send messages in Morse code, or whatever you want. You could even use some software on the PC to read RPM from a game and have it work as a shift light. Not that you'd be looking at it, but, you know, still. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.